So imagine going to your boss and saying, "Hey boss, I realize that the company that I'm attached to has had success for almost 2 decades now, but you know what? Every year we're going to lose tens of millions of dollars under me." I don't know about you, but if I were the boss in that situation, yeah, I'd probably give some walking papers for sure, but in that, maybe I could slip into a little backhandage, you know, because again, ruining the entire company. Now, the reason that I note that at all is because the fourth largest publisher of comic books, IDW, has been utilizing this new social situation for a smokescreen, if you will, talking about how they need to furlough employees now, how certain things have gotten canceled, and of course, that's not their fault. But you know what is? All of the failure that's come before it, all of the failure leading right up to those doors, tens of millions of dollars worth, yeah, and we'll talk about that and the reasoning why. So hey there, so today you and I are returning to that wonderful world of comic books, specifically to talk about IDW here, but also to talk about really the state of this entire industry and how all of this stuff, it didn't just start a few months ago. No, these problems, they were made manifest years ago, and these things, they could have been headed off at the turn again and again. And again, now the first thing that you have to understand about the comic book industry and what pros and companies love to tell you is that, hey, this thing, it's evaluated at $1 billion plus. The problem, of course, is the fact that these numbers, they are deceptive in nature. And when I say deceptive, comic book stores, they bear the brunt of all of this. They have for years, and they've been closing down by the drove since 2017. Now, all of this, of course, is obfuscated by deceptive practice like higher price, like variant covers to the point that some comics have 20 to 40. Of course, a lack of returnability. But if you look at the idea of what's coming in versus unit demand, yeah, unit demand, it has been going down steadily every year. Now, in the past, the answer that you received, it reminded me of the meme in front of you. "Ooh, the house is on fire," someone said. Yeah, don't worry about it. Everything is fine. And of course, if you said anything about it, they would try to tie your reputation in the back room and set it on fire along with the rest of the building. Now, however, the companies are doing an about face and saying, you know what, there are problems, but the problem out there, it's caused by the certain social situation, by the ramifications of it. Yeah, it wasn't anything that we did, and that stuff, it is an out and out lie. Now, I've added quite a few examples to other videos about IDW and the trouble that they get themselves into, but if you don't know anything about comic books, that's fine. Here's you one example. This is just one of many. So the guy that was writing G.I. Joe, you remember what G.I. Joe is as well? He decides to come out and insult Americans on 9/11. He says, "Oh good, it's the self-centered national tragedy remembrance from people who weren't even anywhere near New York City Day." You know, he comes out, he says that, and he doubles down. He triples down and on. He tells people, too, unless you were there or lost someone, this is what your social media remembrance looks like. And he basically says, people, you know, they're clowns during this stuff. Now, you can imagine the reaction to this from G.I. Joe consumers, but also from a lot of other people out there. They didn't quite enjoy it. And apparently, the person in charge of IDW then, and the person that's been rehired to be in charge because no one wants that job, came out in defense of that. This is what he had to say. "The story's gotten spun in such a way that makes us look like the bad guy, and it kills me that that's the case, because that all came about because somebody said things that companies that I don't own took exception to, but I and a couple of others really staked our jobs on not making a rash decision on having that person removed and keeping the book going and even rewarding that person with a new series. Ultimately, the new series, it didn't sell. I'm sure there's all kinds of ideas why it didn't sell, but the fact is, it didn't sell right from the start, so it had to go away. But somehow, rewarding someone with a new book and not giving in to the idiots, you know, of that descriptor, who were trying to put pressure on things, got spun to being that we didn't support this person. That, I think, is the thing that hurts, because we did. We supported him, kept his job, gave him a new book, and it killed me that it didn't work out. Also, at times, I was going to go out there and try to defend it, trying to say no, you're wrong, and keeping the conversation going and giving a forum for people to say more terrible things just felt like a losing battle. My entire time at IDW, I've always approached things as the air is much fresher on the high road. You gotta love that. We're on the high road, you bigots, you idiots, and if you don't like it, well, we're gonna do whatever we want anyhow. Yeah, and these folks, they wonder why they got hit in the pocket so hard. Like I said, there are a lot of examples out there, too. You have people like Diversity in Comics, people like Yellow Flash, they've picked these up for the longest time, and what you see are companies that have damaged themselves. But right now, again, they're pretending that the damage, it just somehow started magically, you know, because they were on the road to recovery. The truth, though, it couldn't be farther from that spin, and the numbers, they actually capture the reality of this dire situation. I mean, if you look back to their fiscal year, 2016, this company, it was actually making good decisions, and it was actually making money. You can see their year end. This is an entire year end. They made $3.669 million. That's in millions again. And then in 2017, the wheels, they just fall off and everything falls apart. See, in these kind of reports, remember that brackets, they always equal monetary loss. And for 2017, you see them pulling all kinds of stuff where they take out huge loans, they go out and they create more stock, but they still end up with a loss for the year at almost $800,000. And again, that's not a reduction from here to here. That's across the board losses. That's everything they made for the year. And if you're looking at that and thinking, wow, $700,000 in loss and that's all you make for the year, yeah, things get a lot worse for the company. Here in 2018, for example, if you look at those numbers, you notice the brackets again, and that's $36,022,000 in loss. The entire year ends up with that much money in the pot. Now, in 2019, the company was actually bragging, saying they were getting things back in alignment. They were doing a better job. And you know what they based that on? Only losing $26,429,000. Now, it's well documented, too, that during that time of turmoil, there was quite a bit of transition with everybody and their mother giving their walking papers. Of course, you don't call it that. They take sabbaticals and on. But yeah, here's the CEO slash co-founder of the company taking a quote-unquote sabbatical. You know things are bad when a person that was co-founding the company needs to take a walk. Otherwise, the stockholders, yeah, they're going to get the impression that everything's falling apart. You have the president also leave IDW Entertainment. I think that says plenty, too. The guy that I was quoting earlier, talking about what happened with Aubrey Sitterson, he was giving his walking papers, but he was allowed to return because no one else wants to ride that ship. In fact, even the CEO that came in, he left after 6 months to tell you what kind of problem it was. I mean, even the guy that's out there in PR trying to spin this place, he leaves. He's probably thinking, man, I can't deal with this, and it gives you an idea of what's going on. Now, what's insane about this year is that you'll have a lot of spin. Companies will be given an out. I mean, you see that transpiring right now, and the government, they may indeed step in and give companies like this money, but if you look at the reality of the numbers, these problems, they already were going on. First quarter of 2020, if you look at the numbers here, net loss attributable to IDW Media Holdings, they had lost $6.8 million. And again, that's within their 3 months. That starts, you noticed, in October. So we're talking about impacts that happened well before all of these social situations. But again, at the end of the year, it will all be credited to that and that alone. Mark my words. I mean, you see articles like this, for example, talking about IDW putting Larry Hama's long-running G.I. Joe series on hiatus. And again, that's going to be blamed on this current social social situation. Now, that, of course, asks you to ignore things like this from the same people. One of them, talking about consumers that they don't agree with here, came up to me at a con and demanded to know why I unfriended and blocked him. And I told him I didn't want to see his ist bleep in my feed, and he said, "But we're still okay, right?" He's mocking a consumer because that consumer was disgruntled about the way that comic books have been treated. Yeah, he treats them like absolute garbage, but, you know, that doesn't have any impact. That doesn't have any impact at all. See, I'm tired of these companies lying about this stuff. They lose tens of millions of dollars. They're going to want money from you to basically recoup from it, and they don't deserve it at all. That's probably one of the most infuriating things about this, the spin versus the reality. Because the reality is, they lost this stuff a long time ago, and many of them, they don't care because they think that they're rock stars and on. But anyhow, you tell me what you think about this stuff. Now, ending this too, I want to say thank you for showing up. Thank you for participating. You make this stuff possible. Without you, none of this works. And well, you know, a certain company's out there, they should have learned that lesson a long time ago. Now, I don't want to monopolize your time, but I do want to thank you for it. And I also want to say, you like this content, you want to sub to the channel and share videos, definitely do so. But, you know, you being here, that matters. So thank you. I do appreciate you. And until next time, we'll see you soon.